Hi, I'm Torben Janssen from thoughtsonjava.org, and today I want to show you why you shouldn't use CascadeType REMOVE and what to do instead. The CascadeTypes REMOVE and ALL provide a comfortable option to remove an entity together with all its child entities. But that creates several issues for too many associations, and you should only use it for two-one relationships. Most developers worry about deleting too many database records when they use CascadeType REMOVE. And that's definitely an issue. But it's only one of the two main problems. The other one is bad performance caused by too many queries. Let's start with the lesser problem, the bad performance. Your application might be slow, but it at least doesn't lose any data. I prepared this simple example. The publisher entity has a one-to-many association to the book entity, and I set the cascade type to remove. When you now remove a publisher entity, Hibernate will also remove the associated book entities. Everything seems to be fine as long as you don't activate the logging of the executed SQL statements. As you can see, Hibernate performed 6 SQL statements to remove 1 publisher and 3 associated book entities. And this even gets worse with every additional book the publisher has published. The first select statement was triggered by the emfind method and returned the publisher entity I want to delete. The second one gets all associated book entities. In this case, the query returns 3 books. Hibernate executes 3 additional delete statements to remove them one by one, and then it finally deletes the publisher entity. That was just a small example with 3 associated entities. But it's good enough to show how inefficient this approach is. That's especially the case for huge too-many associations. On a production system, you can easily trigger several hundred queries by just removing one entity. You get even bigger problems if you use CascadeType REMOVE on a many-to-many association. That not only triggers a lot of SQL statements, but you might also delete more database records than you expected. Here's another example. An author writes multiple books, and a book can be written by multiple authors. My small test database contains 2 authors and 3 books. Book 1 was written by author 1, book 2 by author 1 and author 2, and book 3 was written by author 2. You can easily model that with an author and a book entity and a many-to-many association. And as you can see here, I've set the cascade type to remove on the author entity. When you now remove the author entity with ID 1, you probably expect that Hibernate also removes the book with ID 1. But what about the book with ID 2? Author 1 wrote it together with author 2. So you would probably want to keep it and just remove the association to the removed author. But Hibernate removes the book as well, as you can see in the log output. And it gets even worse when you specify the cascade type remove on both ends of the association. When you now remove the author entity, Hibernate cascades the operation to all associated book entities. From there, it cascades it to all associated authors, and from there to their books, and so on. That deletes a lot more records than you probably expected when you removed the author entity with ID 1. In the worst case, this removes the whole database. Okay, so what's the better approach? First of all, you shouldn't use the CascadeType REMOVE for too many associations, and that's also the case for CascadeType ALL, which includes the CascadeType REMOVE. When you don't use cascading, you need to delete the associated entities yourself. You can either do that by calling the remove method of the entity manager for each entity, or with a bulk operation. Removing the entities one by one is the easiest, but not the most efficient approach. But you can at least be sure that you don't delete any records by accident. You need to iterate through the list of associated books and check if it's associated with any other author. If it's not, you call the remove method for it. Otherwise, you just delete the association to the author entity. As I said, this is not a very efficient approach. Hibernate has to perform two SQL delete operations for each book entity you want to remove. One to remove the book entity, and another one to remove the records from the association table. And if you just want to remove the association to the author entity, Hibernate has to delete the record from the association table. So in the end, Hibernate performs 4 select, 1 update, and 4 delete operations to delete the author with ID 1 and the book with ID 1. And it also removes the association of book 2 with author 1. When your association contains a lot of entities, it's better to remove them with a few queries. This approach is much more complicated than the one I showed you before, but it needs a fixed number of queries to remove an author with all associated books and performs much better for huge associations. As you can see, this approach consists of 4 steps. You first get the IDs of all books that author 1 wrote alone and store them in a list. These are the ones you need to delete in a later step. In the next step, you remove all records from the association table that are linked to author 1. So now, book 1 is not associated with any authors, and book 2 is only associated with author 2. That allows you to remove book 1 without violating a foreign key constraint. Now you need to clean up the book table and remove all books that author 1 wrote alone. You already got the list of books you need to delete in the first step. You now just need to provide it to an in clause of an SQL delete statement. And in the final step, you remove the author entity. As you can see in the log output, Hibernate performed 5 queries. Okay, that's it for today. If you want to learn more about Hibernate, you should join the free Thoughts on Java library. It gives you free access to a lot of member-only content like a cheat sheet for this video and an ebook about using native queries with JPA and Hibernate. I'll add the link to it to the video description below. And if you liked today's video, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe below. Bye!